I found a diary that I wrote when I was 17 years old, okay. Lorraine. And it was so ludicrous and hilarious that I was like, other people need to see this. And so those diary entries are littered throughout the book.
Yeah, they are hilarious.
And do you
what were
like
you thinking?
I mean, what was I... It's, they're so bad.
It's crazy. Absolutely
they're
crazy.
They're so ridiculous. And so they're throughout the book, and then I thought, oh, it would be nice to mix that naivety with yes. with sort of learning slowly throughout my sort of my dating career, I think you can call it.
Because at 17, you thought you would find the one
yeah.
after you'd had or slept with or been with, romance. I don't know what the word is.
Entwined.
Entwined. 40 women.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah, when I was, I put a diary entry in that was, I said I didn't want to have a sex with more than 40 people. That's what I said when I was 17.
You should be so blinking lucky, mate.
I know, right? I know. And so I set myself a limit. I was like, no more than that.
No more than that.
And so it's me trying to sort of pace my way through and see where I am in that
oh,
when I find
geez.
The diary.
I love the bit in it. You know, everybody's always, when they write a book, they've always got like a sort of like, I dedicate this to
oh, yeah.
whoever. Look, Mum, I wrote a book. That's what you
it's
said.
True.
Exclamation mark. And what does your mum think?
My mum was actually the first person to read, considering it's a you know, it's a lot of stories about me
uh-huh.
and my sexual liaisons. My mum was the first person to read it, and I called her up, and the ending's quite emotional, as
yeah.
I'm sure you know. And so she was crying, and I was like, oh, Mum, have you finished the book? And she was crying, which is always a bad thing when someone's just read your book. And I was like, what do you think of it? And she went, oh, Joel, it's so much better than I thought it was going to be. Like, how
right.
bad did you think it was going to be? How untalented do you think your child is?
But that's good. That's a sort of mum thing.
Yes, okay.
And that's absolutely fine. I was really interested. I had no idea you had a sex scene with Sienna Miller in
I
a
know.
Movie.
I've never really talked about it before.
I know, but we never saw it, though, did we?
No.
What happened? Were you so rubbish that you couldn't show it?
This is the mad thing, because I was 20, and 1920, and I'd only had sex with one person before in my life.
Right.
And then they were like, oh, do you want to have do a sex scene with Sienna Miller? And I was like, I don't think I know how to do it in real life, let alone to pretend how to do it. I was suddenly panicking. I was like, maybe oh. I've been doing it weird with this one person.
Because you don't know.
It's going to be on film forever.
Yeah.
And I'm going to go like, oh, this is how you do it, Sienna. And she's like, no, this is not how you do it. And it said in the script, it said entwine in passion. And
right.
So I was like, maybe it's a hug. Maybe it's not. Sex?
I'm not
know.
Sure how you entwine.
No, I have no
that's
idea.
A difficult one.
What is that? Is that a sort of, you know?
I know.
You know, it's a complex sort of yoga hug.
But did you get
and
through it? All right.
I had no idea what it was. And so me and Sienna, we both asked the director, we were like, oh, what is this? This amazing flamboyant American director. We were like, oh, what does entwine with passion mean? And he went, oh, whatever you straight people do. And we were like, that,
well,
I mean,
thanks for that.
That doesn't help at all, mate. It doesn't help at all. And we sort of went through it, we did it.
Oh,
and it wasn't like a full sex scene, but we sort of did lots of stuff. And then it was cut out of the movie. It was replaced.
After all that.
Yeah, it was replaced with the classic film metaphor of a train going through a tunnel.
Right.
I was replaced with a steaming
That's
train.
So sad.
Livid.
So
now it's my
sad.
Word against everybody else's.
I know
I
you
promise it happened.
Did it happen?
I promise.
It wasn't just a dream. It wasn't just a dream.
No.
You sort of used the book as a proposal in a way.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's a 90,000 word proposal to my girlfriend. I at the end I proposed to Hannah Cooper.
She's
there she is,
beautiful.
Look at her face. She's such a good looking one, isn't she?
She is gorgeous. You're gonna have amazing babies
oh,
if you want
she's
to.
So great.
Yeah.
And I made her read the book, the first copy, that, and I made her read it, and I ripped out the last page, and then she rang me up, she's like, I've finished it, but why is the last page ripped out? And I said, oh, I'm not sure on the end. And then she came home, and then I read her the last page on one knee. And I cried more than she did,
you
definitely.
Romantic boy.
Thank you
That's
so much.
Gorgeous.
I was wearing a velvet tuxedo. And she was wearing a Rod Stewart T-shirt, and she kept on being like, I'm so underdressed for this. I'm so underdressed for this. I found out on that day that if you're wearing a velvet tuxedo and you have 150 candles in a tiny London flat,
yeah,
it gets very hot very quickly.
It would do. And trying to get the stains out as well, the wax.
Absolutely. I'm sweating really profusely. Just trying to read
but
a page.
But it's all right. It all happened and it's all gorgeous.
I'm so glad you've read it.
And she was 41.
She was the 41th.
So it all did work out.
It all worked out perfectly. My
teenage
dream.
Do you know what? It's really funny, as I would expect.
Thank you, Lorraine.
But it's also gets you as well.
Yeah.
It really does. You can, and also there's bits, I know you're a chap, but there's bits in it that I thought, oh gosh.
Yeah.
I remember doing that, or I remember thinking that, or that was how weird and awkward I felt.
Yeah, that's
so it's really good.
And I want to make sure people don't think it's sort of a book of sexual exploits where I'm like, yeah, what a lad.
No, not at all.
You know, basically.
No, the exact opposite. Exact opposite. It's hilarious.
I'm
absolutely
so glad
hilarious.
I've been doing so many interviews where people are like pretended to read it. It's so nice to talk to someone who's actually read it. Like, because you've genuinely, and it's so nice because people go like, oh, it's so nice, the ending. And I'm like, you just went to the last page. I know you. I know your game.
Oh, no, Joel, I thought it was great. It made me howl. It was just really, really funny.
Oh, thank you.
Good luck with it. Good luck with everything that you do.
Thank you. Good luck with everything you do, Lorraine.
A joy to see you.
You're such a lovely
person. Thank you,
person.
My love. Oh, God bless you.